protests in Hong Kong have been going on since April of 2019. Some people may judge these people as troublemakers, others may see them as patriots. But let's not forget that even in the United States here, we've had our own rabble-rousers in the past. Sometimes current events are judged differently by historians.
What we got here today is, this was sent from Hong Kong, and with all their protests and everything going on over there, they were wondering about body armor. And they don't have access to what we have here. So one of our viewers sent some aluminum plates. Don't mind the fancy contact paper covering here. But these are about 2.5 millimeter, eighth inch, somewhere right in there. And we're going to try these. This is going to be the first in a series of some different possible body armors that we're going to try out for them. And, we've got four panels here.
What are the police using over there? They have shot a couple protesters.
From what I understand is 38s.
38 specials.
It's like a lot of our police used to use here.
Mm-hmm.
Anyway, we're going to try it out with what do we got? 9mm and 38s, a little bit less power than the 9, so.
Yeah, if they'll stop 9mm, they'll definitely stop a 38 special.
Yeah, exactly. I'm going to try the 1, then we've got up to 4 plates. For now, we're going to see if the aluminum will, I've got my doubts.
But yeah, yeah, especially one plate, you know, I think 9mm in 45 is just going to go right through it like butter.
I think my pellet gun would go through that.
Yeah.
Maybe my slingshot. Are we ready?
One plate, 9mm. I'm ready.
As expected, the single plate of aluminum provided almost no protection at all. The 9mm bullet passed cleanly through the plate and right through the test dummy.
Two aluminum plates, 9mm.
Righty then.
The two aluminum plates, with no space at all between them, didn't perform much better than the single plate. The bullet passed through both plates and again through our test dummy. So far, the aluminum plate body armor idea is not looking very promising.
It must be from some kind of furniture, or a door or something.
Somebody's building something, this was not for it, but we're going to go for 3 layers, so we're just going to do this, fold this over.
Well, there you go.
There we go.
Okay.
3 layers.
Okay, now 3 plates, again with 9mm. Okay, I'm ready. Hey, your aim's getting better.
Well, they say the third time is the charm, and it looks like we've have a successful bullet capture this time.
Positive results this time, Danny?
I think we're a little bit better off this time. Dougie might have survived. Here on the table. What? Is our bullet. And let's pull the plates. And no pass through.
Oh, it almost did.
We got a one finger bulge here. It's almost like sweater bumper. Okay, we passed through the first panel. There's the aluminum from the first panel. It did not pass through the second panel.
Okay.
There's that. There's second panel.
So, should we put the fourth panel on there just to see if we get less of a bulge in the back?
Let's see what happens. That was interesting.
Four layers. These are coming out of like a 10-inch barrel too, by the way. So we have a little higher velocity than out of a handgun. Okay, four layers ready. Stopped it again. Okay, good.
Little punches of aluminum. It's punching out.
Oh yeah. I thought there was a good chance four layers would not even stop the 9mm, so I'm just kind of surprised that three did.
Well, that ball ammo, you would think it would have the best chance of getting through.
Right, yeah, that's why we're not using the hollow points. Ball ammo will have penetrate something like that better than a little better than a hollow point.
So far, we've only had two go all the way through.
Yeah.
Those are one and two plates. Second plate. Third plate. Again, it stopped it on the third plate.
Okay. So you need at least three plates of these, or?
Three plates for 9mm ball ammo.
What about 45? Okay, 230 grain.
230 grain.
45 ACP. Most powerful round on the planet, according to some people. 45 ACP, one layer. Let's make a bet. Do you think it'll go through?
I'm almost going to guarantee it.
Yeah, it's going to go through. Okay, I'm ready when you are.
As expected, the 45 ACP easily penetrated the single layer of aluminum plate.
Okay, two layers of aluminum, 45 ACP. Ready when you are.
Much to our surprise, two layers of this aluminum actually stopped the 45 ACP. Remember that 45 ACP is twice the weight of the 9mm used in these tests, but the velocity is also lower. The energy from each bullet is actually very similar, but because the 9mm has a smaller profile, it's able to penetrate the plates much better.
Kind of settles the 45 versus 9mm argument, doesn't it?
Well, 45 might knock you on your butt, but the 9mm's got better penetration.
Yeah, it's smaller diameter and higher velocity. So the two plates stopped it, right?
Right.
That's amazing. I did not expect that.
It did crack the second plate, but we didn't get a pass through. In fact, it really didn't pass through the first one.
Yeah.
Second one backed it up.
Interesting. I thought it would take probably three to stop the 45 also. Well, that's amazing. Okay. But will it stop the 357, Governor?
Okay. We're going to find out.
Four plates of aluminum plate versus a 357 Magnum.
And these are critical defense. I don't have ball ammo for that.
Oh, okay. Sorry about that. We'll just take one shot.
Yeah.
Okay, 357 Magnum. I don't think the police use 357. They're using 38 and 9mm, but wouldn't it be good to know if it'll stop a 357 Magnum? I don't think it will. We got four layers there.
My prediction is it's going to go through. Okay, I'm ready. Of it going all the way through.
No.
Okay, what happened?
Let's strip her down here. All right. First plate. There's our second plate.
Stopped it in the second plate.
Amazing. Almost went through. Little dent in the third plate.
I thought for sure that would go through.
Well, these are the critical defense Hornady's.
Okay.
Hornaday, however you want to pronounce it. Potato, potato.
Yeah.
But this is meant to expand and mushroom. It's got the polymer.
Yeah, but in a soft hydrostatic condition, you know. But I thought that would go all the way through.
Kind of stuck in there.
Yeah. Very interesting. Well, I had no, I gave these things no hope at all. I really did. I thought, man, if it stops a 9mm, I'd be very, very surprised. But as we saw, it stopped a 9mm in three, sometimes two. So if you have three plates of these, it'll stop a 9mm. It'll definitely stop 45 and 357 Magnum. Did not expect that.
Yeah, they might stand a chance.
Yeah. This is what I call better than nothing body armor. It's your chances of surviving with something like this is a lot better than not having anything.
Oh yeah, it's definitely going to slow it down enough to you might survive.
Yeah, reduce the injury, but probably save your life. I hope this information's is useful. I imagine toting around these things strapped to your chest would not be very comfortable, but it will save your life.
Covers the vitals.
Yeah. Good luck, Hong Kongers. You're going to need it.